Yeah, just generally just very disappointed in our effort tonight, because I was so pleased with how we had played the last three games. I felt like we were making progress. I felt like us digging a hole and not fighting to get out of it, I thought that we had matured enough and grew enough that we would figure out how to get past that. We've been in this situation a couple times now this year, and you know, for our guys to kind of, I wouldn't say quit, but for them to kind of not find it in them to dig ourselves out of holes and keep continue to fight is disappointing, because I thought that we had made so much progress over the last three games. And so, you know, we just have to get back at it now on the 26th when we practice and try to figure out how to find some more fight in our guys.
Was their press pretty much what you expected it to be?
It was better than what I expected. I mean, on film, you see it, and, you know, you see them turning people over at a high rate. We had a one-day prep, and we tried to simulate it and show our guys what to expect with practice yesterday and with shoot around today. But until you actually have to go through it and feel it, our guys, they just weren't. They weren't ready for how physical it is, how quick those guys were to the ball. You know, we just in practice you try to simulate it, but you can't, you know.
Don felt like that you guys had prepared them, but that the team didn't follow the game plan.
I wouldn't say didn't follow the game plan. What happens with us, and what has happened a couple times this year, is once we get into a hole, and dig ourselves a hole, our guys get sped up. You know, there's a couple times where, you know, they start off hot, they get a 9-point lead, and then all of a sudden we're just doing things that we never do. You know, Don advances it to gets a steal, and he advances it too far to Juwan, which that would have been a layup. Darius comes down, he sees Don open, and he passes me the ball. I mean, just doing things that's just not very characteristic of what we do as a team or as a program. And so we have to be able to mature and be able to handle pressure a little bit more.
Is there some number against a team like that of turnovers that you'd consider acceptable in a high-tempo, high-possession game like that?
Well, the problem was they got a majority of them in the beginning of the game. You know, if it's a situation where they're going to get their steals, they're going to turn you over. But for them to be compiled in the very beginning of the game, it just sets a bad tone for us. And so, you know, to start the game like that, if they make a run in the end of the first half, or, you know, beginning of the second half or something like that, you can kind of weather that. But for that to be the way that we start a game is never good.
Don was saying that he felt like the team wasn't focused enough, and you know, maybe after the three-game winning streak, the head got a little bit. Did you see that? And how tough is it to keep a young team focused?
I didn't. You know, we traveled yesterday. We got back. We practiced. Didn't do too much because I didn't want to kill their legs after traveling all day and having a game today. I didn't get the sense that we wouldn't be ready to play. I didn't get the sense that we wouldn't be ready to play. And so I don't know where their focus was, but from my vantage point, I thought that we'd be ready. I felt good about this game. And you know, maybe it's momentum coming from the other three wins. But I felt good about it. I thought we performed today.
Now, you guys, you've shown the ability to bounce back after the Central Arkansas loss. You won three in a row. Mm-hmm. Are you confident in this team and their ability to respond to any of the conference?
I am. And you know, we didn't fight today, and typically, you know, they'll be able to get it together. I feel good about them being able to get it together. And you know, I think that we have the type of team that we could be upset by anybody any given night, or we could upset anybody on any given night. That's as a coach, that's a hard place to be, because it's both sides of the spectrum. But you know, we've got good kids, and they and you know, hopefully, you know, they learn from this situation and they're ready to play on the 30th.
You kind of touched on the spectrum of this team, where you've gone from losing to Central Arkansas to being up against Wichita State and stuff. Mm-hmm. What do you think accounts for that spectrum? Is it just youth, or what do you think accounts for that, do you think?
It's a combination of youth, and I think that, you know, our older guys could be more vocal, more take charge, you know. You know, I put a lot of pressure on Kingsley and Marcus to lead this team, and Nick Hamilton to lead this team. And, you know, I think that I'm continually every day challenging Marcus. Marcus is kind of a quiet kid. Kingsley is as well. But, you know, this is the last go-round for those guys. And so I'm challenging them every day to do a better job of leading this team and not letting the freshman lead us, or you know, Don Coleman's a junior, letting Don lead the team. I'm challenging those guys to lead this team.
Coach, your team averages about 13.5 threes a game. That's the point up to 8, maybe done. What did you see from your perimeter shooting today? Or
well, that wasn't the focus. The focus was to get the ball into the paint and not have to rely on 3-point shooting to you know, because they're an undersized team. You know, they played Edwards 14 minutes tonight. So when Edwards wasn't in the game, their biggest guy was 6'6", you know, and so we've got Marcus, we've got Kingsley. So the game plan was to try to get paint touches and get the ball into the post. And so we knew that we weren't going to outshoot this team. You know, they're a very good shooting team. So our game, our strategy was to capitalize in the paint. And we turned the ball over at such a high rate that we didn't allow ourselves to even be able to exploit that.
What did you think of their point guard, Woods?
I thought he was great. I thought he was a great point guard. He ran his team. He's very unselfish. I mean, he finishes up with, I don't know how many assists.
13 and one turnover.
Yeah, 13 assists, one turnover. He did it. He was a very talented young man. He was good. Shot the ball 6 times, 3 for 6. He didn't look to do too much. He was very talented. He was good.
Final questions for Coach?
You guys come back right after Christmas. What would you like to see you guys accomplish before that?
I just like to see more fight at this point. I thought we had made tremendous strides in that area. After road win at San Diego State, overtime, you know, Fullerton 20-point win against Seattle. I thought that we had made tremendous strides in those areas in fighting and executing and staying focused. And we just took a step in the wrong direction tonight.
Said a lot. Of course, we were disappointed. You know, we all disappointed. We could have gave more effort out there, but, I mean, we can only learn from it, move on, and get ready for conference.
What was it about their press that caused so many problems?
Nothing, man. I mean, we practiced it. The coaches had us ready for the press. We just didn't execute the game plan. We let them down.
I think you guys have won 3 in a row coming in. What's the difference when you guys get on a roll like that and then kind of going backward a little bit tonight?
I just think we wasn't focused, to be honest. I don't think we was focused today. We won 3 straight. I think we got the big head. Thought we was going to come in, blow them out, and see the outcome. Can't do that.
What was the biggest sort of difference from these guys versus the previous 3 teams that you had beaten?
They pressed us. I mean, obviously we can't break a press. I guess we got to keep working on it. But, I mean, they got into us. They pressed us. We had like 50 points off turnovers. Can't win like that.
You guys have bounced back after a tough loss like this, after the Central Arkansas loss you went 3 in a row. Are you confident in your team's ability to respond to this type of adversity?
Oh, of course. I mean, this is a tough loss, like I said, but, I mean, it's on to the next game. Get ready for conference and get focused on Stanford once we get back from break.
How much time do you guys have off now?
I think like 2 days, 3 days. We practice on the 26th, so I think like 2-3 days.
So Coach had a lot to say in the post-game locker room. What was the reaction like from the players? What's the vibe from you guys?
I mean, disappointed, man. I mean, Nobody want to lose like that to, I mean, that's a good team, but we supposed to beat them. Like, we know that. And to lose by 25, that's disappointing. So, everybody's pretty much mad. Coaches yelled at us, everything. They said a lot of stuff, but we're going to bounce back from it. I'm sorry.
Is everything else? What do you think it is about you guys that makes you be kind of up and down? We've seen you guys be so up against like a Wichita State team. You're playing against them tough. You drop the Chaminade. You guys jump to Central Arkansas. The next night, you guys bounce back against San Diego State. What do you think accounts for that kind of fluctuation, you think?
I think we're young, but I mean that's not an excuse. But I think we're young. I think I gotta hold myself more accountable to lead the young guys. I don't think I believe them correctly, so I take the blame on that one. But we're a young team, and I think some games we come in not focused as we should be. Like when we play San Diego State, we're focused, locked in. When we come and play Portland State, we not locked in. We just think we're gonna go past them and win, which is not the case, and that's the outcome. So we just gotta be locked in every game.
You guys good? Okay, thanks, Don.
Thanks, Don. Appreciate it.